Today I'm presenting the results of two experiments conducted in two labs with two different cells, human cells, demonstrating that subtle energy is able to maintain high viability of cells in both food deprivation condition and toxic environment. All energy patterns which were used in these experiments are created with help of vital force technology equipment. I spoke about principles of vital force technology on previous conferences, but I assume that not all of you were there. And I will briefly repeat these principles as well as methods used for creating these subtle energy patterns. So, subtle energy is generated by plasma, ion electron plasma, which is controlled by computerized electronic equipment. And of course, it generates mixture of electromagnetic vibrations and subtle energy. And then subtle energy is separated from electromagnetic vibrations. After that, it is recorded in specially created equipment. And recorded energy patterns can be repeated any moment when we need them. And using special infusing system can be infused in any, practically any substance. In our experiments, substances were growth media of cells, for cells, and methods used for creation of these subtle energy patterns were multiple, and these main methods used. First, I learned how to create energy patterns connected to periodic table elements. Then some patterns were created following traditional Chinese medicine principles, like five elemental principles. Some of them were created during experimentation with vital force technology equipment. And we learned also how to copy energy of any substance, including plants, gems, herbs, whatever. And we know how even to record energies of healers' intent. So we can record, let's say, energy of affirmation. If you pronounce affirmations, we can record energy pattern produced by this affirmation. All energies used in these experiments are sophisticated combinations of one or sometimes all of these methods. So main advantage of using technologically generated patterns, of course, is that you can repeat any time this experiment and provide stability of the experimental framework. So experiment number one was done in Beech Tree Labs. Many of you probably know Dr. John McMichael. And Jeremy Innes, who will do next report, was conducting this experiment. In experiment, we used human dermal fibroblasts, HDF, cells grown in media infused with subtle energy patterns, created, as I said, with vital force technology. So experimental setup, this is initial amount of cells in six well plates. So measurement of growth was done with Alamar blue fluorescent tag, and measurement were done every 3 days until for 9 days. So this is the result of these experiments. To create difficult conditions for cells, there was no change of growth media during the whole time of the experiment. And in other words, cells grew until they began to die. This first set of data presents results during growth period, and second is when cells already began to die. Growth media was infused with these four different subtle energy patterns. You can see names of these energy patterns. They were created specifically for purpose corresponding to their names. And you can see that all four energy patterns overperform the control significantly. So in the first set of data, you can see that this energy pattern, which is called cell longevity, showed the best result. And I need to stress that this pattern was specifically created for support of cell health. So during dying period, another pattern demonstrated the best results. It was stress relief. But cell longevity and third pattern, which is called peak performance, also demonstrated very high ability to support viability of cells. So as I said, all four patterns was significantly higher, supported higher viability than the control. This stress relief, it was a surprise for everybody that this pattern, which was created for really for stress relief for human being, supported also cells' viability during dying period very effectively. Like you see that it provided 83% more cells than in control. Two of the best energy patterns, cell longevity and peak performance, were chosen for next experiment, which was done in University of Latvia. And besides cell viability, in this experiment, mitochondrial membrane potential was used not only under food deprivation condition, but also when mitochondrial toxin was added to media. So this is experimental setup. They were grown in regular medium. Then for 3 days, medium was added containing energy patterns. And then they were in food deprivation condition for 3 days. And then cells viability was measured. This is the result. You can see that both cells longevity and peak performance energy patterns overperformed significantly control. Now, in some wells, on sixth day was mitochondrial toxin added. It's called MMP plus. I cannot even pronounce this sophisticated chemical formula. Anyway, this is the result. When cell viability was measured on seventh day, on 24 hours after this mitochondrial toxin was added, you can see that in control, which was grown in toxic media, amount of cells, their viability was significantly less than in control, which didn't have mitochondrial poison. And both, again, cells longevity and peak performance overperformed not only poison control, but also non-poison control, which means that these energy patterns very significantly supported cells viability. Now, when mitochondrial potential was measured in reference to control, you can see also that mitochondrial poison was not able to suppress mitochondrial activity in energy-infused media. Cells longevity and peak performance both demonstrated, again, better supported better mitochondrial potential than even non-poison control. So I want to make some conclusion that technologically generated subtle energy patterns targeted for support of cellular health showed strong ability to provide high viability for two types of human cells in food deprivation and toxic environment. I presented before some other experiments done with subtle energy patterns technologically generated. They included strong increase of survival rate of damaged cells damaged by gamma radiation, suppression of proliferation of cancer cells, normalization of the adaptive response to stress, and so on. Clearly, there is increasingly more evidence that subtle energy truly deserves the title of the life force given to it by the ancients. Next report will further confirm subtle energy rights for this title. It will demonstrate the ability of subtle energy to act on the genetic level. Thank you for your attention, and sorry I didn't show any cats pictures.
We can have a few minutes for questions.
Thank you. I'm intrigued by your suggestion that you can measure energy fields from healers, is that what you said?
We cannot measure it. We can record it and record. Then see effect of it.
Can you show us a recording of that or tell us what such a recording looks like?
How? You mean how we recorded it? I cannot show you because I don't have equipment here, but I can describe you how we did. Like if you take bottle of regular trace minerals in your hand, and pronounce, let's say, affirmation or prayer or whatever you want to say, like, I hate you, I hate you. And we will put it in our equipment. We can record this energy. And then it will be forever there in the storage of our database, subtle energy database. We can reproduce it anytime, and you can conduct experiments and see effect of this energy pattern. And we did recording of prayers, affirmations, and they work very well. We recorded prayer after meal and then did blind experiment with people asking what it's doing. They said it helps digestion.
Yeah, question about the, you have a sense of the effectiveness of the different methods, like the plant part. You said you took essences of plants compared to the healing energies. You were doing several things, right? Several processes to treat your...
In these experiments?
Yes.
Yes. It was very... all these patterns are very different combinations of many components, which were experimentally tested for a long time and then finally combined into energetic... So we call them energetic formulas.
Dr. Cronin, can you... Is this working?
Almost no.
Testing.
I barely can hear you.
Yeah, Dr. Cronin, thank you for a fascinating presentation. I wonder if you have done a sham-controlled study on humans with the same kind of medical disorder that has discrete biological markers and measured outcomes both at the cellular level as well as the functional level in humans. For example, diabetes or something where there are markers that are easy to gauge empirically. If you've done a study like this, infusing a healing energy pattern that works when a healer, energy healer uses it, getting that pattern in the machine and suffusing it into the human, and then measuring outcomes and comparing them to what may happen. If you could comment on that, that would be interesting.
We would love to do this kind of experiment, but we didn't do yet. You know, it need to have doctors who agree to do this kind of experiments. And if we find, if you know somebody, let us know. We would be happy to do it.
One more question. I think you were the first hand I saw.
Could you talk a little bit more about the technology, like how are you recording the subtle energy and then transmitting it into the cells, like the actual vital force technology? What's the mechanism?
You know, it takes a lot of time to describe, and I cannot do it right now. We can talk after conference. But mainly there are some coils, if you wish, in a certain magnetic field configuration, we're sending this energy by wires to these infusers, and these infusers radiate amplified subtle energy on whatever substance you put in front of it. And it infuses, and by the way, these energy patterns live in these infused media for years, which shows that energy significantly changes properties. I have some ideas how it happens, but it's a long story.
Thank you, Dr. Krohn.